big game changer, and it's out in 3G, and it's also coming out in 4G in kind of dual mode, are what are called MiFi devices. And there's been a wireless standard that's been out there for a long time, and it's almost ubiquitous, called Wi-Fi.
Right.
And you have, you know, 425, 500 million, whatever the number of devices, active Wi-Fi devices that are out there in the U.S. right now, that now can become mobile with these little pucks that are like a cable modem and a Wi-Fi router in your pocket. And that's the 3G version. The 4G version.
And that'll do what for you if you have that?
What it'll allow you to do is take five devices with you on the road. It could be your phone, your phone, your PC, your netbook, right, your MP3 player, your gaming device,
right,
your camera, your camcorder, and they're all connected to the internet. So your hotspot is no longer the size of a coffee shop or the size of your apartment. It's the size of a city or the size of a country. And so at 3G speeds, they operate really well. But at 4G, I think you're going to see the adoption of these devices. So, you know,
so everybody will carry their own Wi-Fi spot.
People will carry these devices because they'll be... all of these devices can be mobile, and you're going to start to see Wi-Fi put almost ubiquitously in everything, and it can work so much faster than it can on what we'll call the phone network. I saw a stat just this week that supposedly 44% of iPhone use is over Wi-Fi because it's so much faster than the AT&T network, which is akin to a 4G speed. So you have, and this is what's been kind of one of the big changes that I've seen in the industry. It's been typically 10, 15 years between generations, 1G to 2G to 3G. And I remember when 3G investments were being made and there was all the spectrum being auctioned years ago, it was like, well, what are the applications? Why do we need 3G? 3G is barely in the ground and everybody's moving 4G. So we're launching all sorts of 4G cities.
So you know, just tell us the difference in 3G and 4G.
5X.
So it's just that.
Each generation is basically half an order of magnitude. So what you would get, and the reason I would care, is not only do I get five times the speed, but because of cost, I can get my bucket of gigabytes instead of minutes. It used to be a bucket of minutes in the voice world. The amount that I can use about five times as much for the same price as well. So that's why I care. And the experience is more like the home cable modem experience in terms of speed. So it's truly like a mobile hotspot when you get to 4G. I think you're going to see an explosion in the number
of
mobile
devices. But how many
mobile
devices do you want to be carrying around with you?
Well, it's going to be up to the individual, what I want to carry for what I'm doing. So what's been happening in the industry as we move to, let's say, smartphones, which is 3G, is they're really becoming Swiss Army knives. And, you know, it's, of course, my watch and my calendar and my email. It's my camera. It's my GPS. It's my computer. But you have to make compromises on each of those to be able to have them all in one device. So what I think we're going to see is, smartphones will be able to do more and more and more things that you add them into that smartphone. Right. But with these hockey pucks, I say, you know, when I would like to take a digital SLR camera with me and take it at 15 megapixels. But the reason that I've been taking the camera version is I want to upload that picture right now. But if it's got Wi-Fi in it, and also if it has 4G, it would take forever to take a 15 megapixel camera shot and shoot it up and share it with somebody on 3G, but on 4G, it's like that. So that's why I care about 4G. So with 4G, all of these other devices, you know, high definition camcorders, larger screens, if I, let's say, want to watch television on the road or download movies, I may not want to carry it with me all the time. But when I travel, well, like a Kindle, that would be an example. You know, it's a great 3G device, and that runs on the Sprint network.
Right.
It's not something I can carry in my pocket.